Hi, my name is Bill Wiese, and I'm the author of the book 23 Minutes in Hell. Thank you for joining me. Some think God is narrow-minded for stating that there is only one way to heaven. The main reason for this belief is because Satan has inspired a countless number of religions and strange beliefs in order to not only deceive people, but to plant the idea in their mind that since there are so many, why would only Christianity be right? To say there is only one correct way to heaven would seem irrational, prejudiced, and narrow-minded. But first of all, Christianity is not narrow-minded. It's open to all, and its invitation is to all who will come. There are no prejudices. And secondly, it's not narrow-minded, and this analogy will help you understand. Say you invited me over to your home for dinner, and you said, "Bill, I want you to go south on Highway 95, turn right at Main Street, go up the hill, you'll come to my house. But that's the only way to get to my house." And I say to you, "You know what? I think I'm going to go north on 95. I'm going to get off at Beach Boulevard because I think all roads lead to your house. That's what I think." Well, you're going to tell me, "Bill, you're not going to get to my house. I'm trying to give you clear directions." Well, the same way, God gives us clear directions to His house. I think God knows where He lives. All we have to do is follow His clear directions and we will get there. That's not narrow-minded, that's specific. He's trying to get us to His house, not keep us out. Now this is His clear directions to heaven. John 3:36 says, "He that believes in the Son has everlasting life, but he that believes not on the Son shall not see life, but the wrath of God abides on him." How do we know the Son? Just two verses. Jesus said in Luke 13:3, "Unless a man repent, you shall all likewise perish." Now repent means to turn away from a sinful lifestyle and commit to following Jesus. And secondly, Romans 10:9 and 10 says, "If we confess with our mouth the Lord Jesus and believe in our heart that God has raised Him from the dead, we shall be saved." Now you can follow His clear directions and live in heaven, or you can disagree and live in hell. It's your choice. If you want to live at God's house, you do it His way. There is only one way, as Jesus said in John 14:6. Now, if you disagree, you will have the opportunity to argue with Him at Judgment Day.